Tonight, we're learning more about the alleged abuse that started nearly 5 years ago. Our Susan L. Corey looking at documents and talking to detectives about how this case finally came to light. Susan?
Well, Kevin, investigators started looking into Mark Holland when a woman who's more than 30 years younger came forward saying Holland kept harassing her, and now she's afraid not only for her safety, but her husband and kids. Behind the barbed wire, former state police trooper Mark Holland poses for his mugshot. He spent less than an hour in the Independence County Jail over accusations that ended his 19 years on the force.
We're here to protect the public, not to harass them.
Sheriff Sean Stevens' office took the first report. A woman came to his detectives concerned Holland was stalking her.
It was very concerning, and we wanted to make sure that this was taken care of.
That's when state police took over. According to this affidavit, Holland started emailing the woman in 2016. Investigators say this year, Holland sent a letter and dozens of emails telling the woman he wanted to perform sexual acts and pay for nude photos. In one message, police say Holland wrote, "If I have to come over there, I'll take my own pics. I'm going to get what I want." The affidavit also says he admitted to looking up the woman's information on a police database and then driving his patrol car by her home several times.
It's concerning that an officer would do this because we hold ourselves to a higher standard.
When questioned, detectives say Holland claimed he was infatuated, fantasized about her, and was irritated that she didn't respond to his emails.
If it had been one of our employees doing it, we'd be going down the same road as they are.
A man once charged to uphold the law now faces 20 felony counts. And I did reach out to Holland. He didn't want to comment. According to investigators, the woman used to work at a gas station that Holland's family owned. Back to you.